Okay, so this is where we last left our discussion. As I have told you, this is the insular lobe. The insula lies deep in the floor of the lateral fissure, almost surrounded by a circular sulcus and overlapped by adjacent cortical areas. They are called as the opercula. The frontal operculum is between the anterior and the ascending rami of the lateral fissure. This is the anterior ascending rami of the lateral fissure, and it forms a triangular division of the inferior frontal gyrus. Yahan par hai frontal operculum. After this is the frontoparietal operculum. It is between the ascending and the posterior rami of the lateral fissure, and it consists of the posterior part of the inferior frontal gyrus and the lower ends of the precentral and the postcentral gyri and the lower end of the anterior part of inferior parietal lobule. So, जैसे कि आपको समझ आ रहा है कि corresponding part जिस जिस lobe का आता जा रहा है उसी से उसके frontal operculum या frontoparietal operculum या temporal operculum का नाम रखा गया है. So, the temporal operculum below the posterior ramus of the lateral fissure is formed by the superior temporal and transverse temporal gyri. These are the transverse temporal gyri. This is the superior temporal gyrus. Anteriorly, the inferior region of the insula adjoins the orbital part of the inferior frontal gyrus. यहाँ पर inferior frontal gyrus होगा और ये इसके orbital part के साथ associate कर रहा है insula. So these are the opercula, you know about it now. Superior temporal gyrus ka part hai, yahan pe lower part of the inferior frontal gyrus ka part hai, precentral gyrus ka part hai, postcentral gyrus ka part hai aur inferior parietal lobule yani ki anterior part of supramarginal gyrus ka part hai. Usi ke sath pars triangularis aur pars orbitalis. So this is where you can see the insular lobe after all the opercula have been removed. They have been cut. So this what you see now is the circular sulcus. Ye circular sulcus iska cut edge hai. So when the opercula are removed, the insula appears as a pyramidal area with apex directed downwards. So this is the region where the circular sulcus is deficient. यानी कि जो आपको dark maroonish boundary दिखाई दे रही है, जो कि cut edge है, वो यहाँ obviously नहीं है. So this is where the circular sulcus is deficient. The medial part of the apex, this is the apex, the medial part is called as the limen insulae or the gyrus ambiens. There is a central insular sulcus, iski baat ho rahi hai. So ye hai central insular sulcus, and it is going to slant posterior superiorly from the apex. It divides the insular surface into a large anterior and the small posterior part. और यहाँ जो आपको ये छोटी छोटी एलिवेशंस दिख रही हैं, इनके नाम है शॉर्ट गायराए और गायराए ब्रेविस इन द एंटीरियर पार्ट विच कैन बी ऑलमोस्ट 3 to 4 इन नंबर्स एंड इन द पोस्टीरियर पार्ट देयर आर 1 to 2 लॉन्ग गायराए और द गायरस लॉन्गस. द कॉर्टेक्स ऑफ द इंसुला इज कॉन्टिन्यूस विद दैट ऑफ ऑपर्क्यूला वेन द फोल्ड इज अकरिंग अलॉन्ग द सर्क्यूलर सल्कस. This is the circular sulcus and this is the insular lobe. Yahan ek line likhi gayi hai jiske anusar the insula is approximately coextensive with the subjacent claustrum and putamen. If you do, yes, this is a transverse section. Transverse section or coronal section is do jagah pe aap is cheez ko identify kar sakte hain. So claustrum, if this is the insular gray matter, internal to it there is something called as claustrum. It is a subcortical collection of gray matter like all your basal nuclei were. This is called as claustrum, and since they are functionally associated with each other, that is why the term coextensive was used. So this is insular lobe, short gyri, long gyri, central insular sulcus, circular sulcus. So here this is the coronal section. You can see that claustrum is a thin sheet of gray matter and it lies deep to insula. Now we come to the occipital lobe. Fir wahi imaginary line number 1 ko yaad karenge posterior lateral surface pe. The occipital lobe lies posterior to it. It contains the following sulci: superior occipital sulci, which is nothing but an extension of intraparietal sulci. It may or may not look like this in a real life specimen, but usually it looks like this. And and inferior occipital sulcus, which is an extension of inferior temporal sulcus. So these two are superior and inferior occipital sulci, and unse bane wahi same teen gyri ka pattern hai, superior occipital gyrus, middle occipital gyrus and inferior occipital gyrus. So a term that you will encounter is lunate sulcus. So lunate sulcus is an inconsistent sulcus. It is also called as the simian sulcus because it is observed in the ape brains. It is a fissure in the occipital lobe, variably found in humans and more often larger when present in apes and monkeys. So this has a phylogenetic significance as it has moved posteriorly and has moved downwards in the Homo sapiens when compared to the other simians. So yeah, talking about the lateral occipital sulcus, in the occipital lobe, the lateral occipital sulcus, if present, divides the lateral or the middle occipital gyrus. This is the middle occipital gyrus. It can divide it into superior and inferior part if it is present there. An anterior portion is usually incomplete, but in some individuals it may encounter the superior temporal sulcus. They may join with each other, while the posterior portion can join with the lunate sulcus if present. So these are some of the inconsistent sulci, or let's just say variably shaped sulci in the occipital region. This one, if lunate sulcus, if present in case of a human brain, might look like something like this. So this is a lunate and this is the lateral occipital sulcus that you can see here. So this is the occipital lobe, and on the medial side, this is where you can see the parieto occipital sulcus. This one is the cingulate, calcarine fissure and the parieto occipital sulcus, and this region is the cuneus between the two of them, and this was the lingual gyrus, as you might remember. So all this region constitutes the medial surface of the occipital lobe. So they are the same thing but labeled now: parieto occipital fissure, calcarine sulcus, lingual gyrus and cuneus, this region between the two of them. This is the collateral fissure and the inferior temporal gyrus. So collateral fissure and the inferior temporal gyrus. So again, just for your revision, you might want to pause and look at all of these again. Next is the limbic lobe. This is the sixth and the final lobe that we are going to talk about, and this one is perhaps the most difficult to understand because it is not as, let's just say, visibly well defined as the rest of the lobes have been. So it includes large parts of gray matter present all across this middle portion of the brain. So it is going to constitute the parts from subcalosal, cingulate gyrus and parahippocampal gyrus and hippocampal formation. It is also going to include hippocampal formation, and hippocampal formation is further divided into multiple parts, or let's just say is constituted by multiple members forming cornu and the dentate gyrus and subiculum. This all will be a separate chapter in itself, but what do you have to understand when you are looking at the visual components of what is given to you? There is, first of all, remember one thing, that there is a close relationship between these phylogenetically old cortical structure. They are associated with the sense of smell, have the sense of memory, and these are old cortical structure, meaning that even when the life forms were not as advanced as humans today are, these were the primary structures which were present in the primitive brains as well. So this is a representation where the parts relating to all of the limbic lobes have been sort of diagrammatically presented to you. So one thing you have to remember, is diagram mein abhi ye do brains, do cerebral halves ek dusre se alag nahi kiye gaye hain. So aapko ye ek side ka cingulate gyrus bhi dikh raha hai, और ये दूसरी साइड का सिंगुलेट गायरस भी दिख रहा है, तो कंफ्यूज नहीं होना, लेट्स जस्ट स्टिक टू वन साइड. दिस इज द सिंगुलेट गायरस एंड एज यू नो ये कॉर्पस कैलोजम के ऊपर वाइंड अराउंड करता है. इस डायग्राम में कॉर्पस कैलोजम नहीं है, व्हाट यू सी इज सिंगुलेट गायरस और उसके नीचे देर इज अ नर्व पाथवे कॉल्ड एज द फॉर्निक्स. दिस पार्ट इज द सेप्टम पेलुसिडम. आपकी सेपरेट क्लास होगी इस पूरी चीज के लिए, आप अभी नहीं भी समझ पा रहे, जस्ट फोकस ऑन द नेम्स. एंड दिस इज द मिड ब्रेन. मिड ब्रेन का पार्ट भी इससे रिलेट करता है, आपको मैंने मिड ब्रेन के वक्त में ये चीज पढ़ाई थी. उसके बाद यहां पर एंटीरियरली यू कैन सी द ऑल्फैक्टरी बल्ब एक्सटेंडिंग बैकवर्ड्स. यू रिमेंबर द मैमिलरी बॉडीज विच आई शोड यू इन दैट डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन. एंड दिस इज योर पैरा हिपोकैम्पल गायरस. इट्स मीडियल एक्सटेंट विल शो यू amygdala and will show you dentate gyrus and this is all going to form the hippocampal formation and it is relating to pons as well. So all these areas relating to each other form this very complex limbic lobe. Now let's just see some part which should be known to us at this stage. First of all, the cingulate gyrus. Jaisa ki maine aapko bataya tha, is diagram mein sirf cingulate gyrus bana hai, corpus callosum nahi bana hai. So this is the cingulate gyrus. It is divided into a rostral part, anterior cingulate, or we can call it. Then there is a caudal anterior cingulate. So this whole thing is anterior cingulate. So it is divided into rostral means facing the nose, caudal means towards the tail, as caudal always means. Then there is posterior cingulate. Then there is isthmus, and then the cingulate gyrus will join the parahippocampal gyrus via this isthmus. So this formation, you have to just know the names at this stage. Next, we come to the parahippocampal gyrus. This is one thing which will be very visible to you when you hold the brain and remove the brain stem. So this includes the areas of entorhinal and medial temporal cortical fields. Medial part of temporal lobe is not very visible unless you manipulate the parts a bit. And obviously, it has complex connections with the rest of the components of limbic lobe. And it surrounds the hippocampus. Now, location of the hippocampus is always one of the very confusing things for the undergraduates. For this, you should look at a figure which we are going to see later, after a few slides actually. So, first of all, entorhinal cortex. It is the area of the brain located in the medial temporal lobe. We understand that at the caudal end of the temporal lobe, it is divided into later and middle entorhinal cortices. So this is the cortex of this area, which we have been calling uncus till all this time. Now we come to the hippocampal gyrus. So hippocampus lies above the subiculum and the medial parahippocampal gyrus. So it is the medial most fold upon parahippocampal gyrus, and you see it when you dissect the lateral ventricle and you reach the roof of it. Why so? It is because of this formation. If this is the temporal horn of the lateral ventricle and this is the side where the choroid plexus is formed and the vessels enter the lateral ventricle, this is what its thin roof is in this area. So what you have to remember is in the temporal region, the lateral ventricle, the temporal horn of the lateral ventricle, as I might say, has the brain portion towards its lateral lateral wall and towards its floor. In its roof, it has the choroid plexus. So while dissecting this whole region, when we reach here and we open the lateral ventricle, we see this indentation caused by the gray matter. Now this is hippocampus, and on the edge is the dentate gyrus. These two gray matter formations form the hippocampus. Let's see more diagrams to get a gist of what it is. This is a better one. See, this is the collateral sulcus. You remember it is on the inferior part. Then this is the parahippocampal gyrus, and this area is what is difficult to see without manipulating the brain. This would look to you like as if you have reached a corner. Aapko dekhne mein aisa lagega ki yahan par ye brain khatam ho gaya, par aisa kuch nahi hai. When you pull the parts apart or you reach here via dissection, you would realize that this thin wall is the source of your entire confusion. The gray matter ends here, the gray matter is floating upwards, but this part of the neural tube is closed by choroid fissure. It is non-neural roof of this entire area. That is why you are always confused about it. So it is nothing but the gray matter, or let's say the cortex folding upon itself, parahippocampal gyrus folding upon to form this formation of alveus and the entire hippocampal formation. And this has to close, right? All the ventricles have a 360 degree closure of ependymion on all the sides, and this is what the remaining part is. So you literally have to either pull these two things apart to see this, or the second approach is that you dissect it, cut here and expose this part. So the best way to see the hippocampus is to dissect the lateral ventricle and see this arising as an elevation into the lateral ventricle. But technically it is coming from outside, folding towards in. Let's see if some other diagram helps you. This is where you can see this. This is a transverse section. And now we have removed the top half of the brain, let's say more than half of the brain. And this cavity is the lateral ventricle. And all of a sudden in the lateral ventricle, you will see these elevations. These elevations are the hippocampus. And this is formed by this up folding. Even if you don't understand it right now, just remember the name so that they are better known to you when you come to the real lecture of this thing. So what you have to remember at this stage is that hippocampus is even more medial to the parahippocampal gyrus. It is so much more medial that it is deeply set into this portion, which is the floor and the lateral wall of the temporal horn of lateral ventricle. Agar aapko ye abhi nahi bhi samajh aa raha hai, still just remember two or three things. Temporal horn of the lateral ventricle, parahippocampal gyrus, which will be visible, and if you explore it going upwards and even more medially, this fold is what is actually the hippocampal formation. Another diagram, see, now you can see this. Agar main hippocampal formation ke bahar is area ki baat karun, to ye kya hai? As you can appreciate, this is the medial most side of the temporal lobe, and this is the fold up turning upon itself. So this is the fold up turning upon itself, and it has been exposed by removing everything on top of it. Subcallosal gyrus, as you can see that under the corpus callosum, there is a thin spread distribution of the gray matter, and that is called as the subcallosal gyrus. So it is a narrow thin lamina on the medial surface of the hemisphere in front of lamina terminalis, which is seen in this area, and para-olfactory area. This is the olfactory tract. The area around is this para-olfactory area. The gray matter above and under the corpus callosum and the genu of the corpus callosum and inducium graecium. What is inducium graecium? It is the thin layer of nerve cells upon the corpus callosum. Corpus callosum to commissural fibers the. Unke upar ek thin layer of gray matter present hai, jiska association hai limbic lobe ke saath. That is called as inducium graecium or the supracallosal gyrus. So this entire formation is a part of subcallosal gyrus. So again a diagram about hippocampal anatomy. This is the parahippocampal gyrus. Ye to baat ab hamesha yaad rakhiye ki parahippocampal gyrus bahut aaram se dikh jayega. And if you go above the parahippocampal gyrus and locate medially, you will find the hippocampal formation. अमिग्डला के बारे में अगेन आपको लिम्बिक लेक्चर के समय में अच्छा से पढ़ाया जाएगा. बट एज फार एज यू शुड नो, अमिग्डला इज अ न्यूक्लियर कॉम्प्लेक्स. सो इट हैज मल्टीपल न्यूक्लिया. एंड व्हाट इज इट्स लोकेशन? इट इज क्लोज टू द टेल ऑफ कॉर्डेट न्यूक्लियस व्हेन यू टॉकिंग अबाउट अ कॉरोनरी सेक्शन, और इवन इन द 3D जियोमेट्री व्हेन यू नो द बेसल गैंग्लिया. एंड इट लाइज डीप टू सेमीलूनर गायरस, गायरस एम्बियंस एंड अनसिनेट गायरस. यानी कि जो ये अनसिनेट प्रोसेस की आप बात कर रहे थे, उसके नीचे अमिग्डुलर न्यूक्लियर कॉम्प्लेक्स है. ये भी टर्म उस वक्त में आएगी, बट जस्ट सो दैट यू आर नॉट कम्प्लीटली लॉस्ट एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम, आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग दिस टर्म टू यू राइट नाउ. सो जस्ट पॉज दिस वीडियो एंड रिवाइज दीज गायराए एंड सल्काए. I hope that you, if you watch these pictures again and again, more and more, you will understand more and more of them. And it will all eventually come to you. See, uncus, parahippocampal gyrus. So something has to be here, right? What happens when this fold is explored? This is the ventricle, this you can see. So that's it for the discussion of gyri and sulci. If you can focus on seeing more and more pictures, whatever confuses you, you should Google it more and more. There is so much of excellent text present everywhere. Unhe dekhiye, books ko dekhiye, videos ko dekhiye, aur tarah tarah ki videos explore kijiye, jisse ki aap isse jitna zyada dekhenge, utna zyada isse samajh payenge. So utilize your time well while you are at home and take good care of your health. Thank you so much.